Masa apa? Masa mais tahal. Oh, wow, lama. Apa khabar anda semua di sana? Khabar baik? Alhamdulillah, I hope you all are doing fine, well and peace be upon you. Today we're gonna make something simple. We're gonna do ikan tongkol belado original. So this is the original of how we make the Indonesian chili. The belado, we call it belado. The Indonesian call it belado because it's simple. It's not a sambal. It's not a blended dry chili. It's making of from fresh chili. So this is the original version of belado. Ni adalah versi original. Jati ni macam mana membuat belado ni eh. So come along with me and I show you how to make ikan masak belado original, or this is the original Indonesian sambal. Okay, first we need ikan tongkol. Ikan tongkol is a bluefin tuna. This is a baby bluefin tuna. Is this long ah, my whole arm long. You can buy in Sheng Siong, only $11. Murah eh, beli kat Sheng Siong. Satu lengan panjang ini anak ikan tongkol ni harga $11 tadi beli. So I ask them to cut into pieces. Saya suruh orang potong eh. Dah siap potong semua. Okay, so bersama air satu periuk gini, kita akan rebuskan dia dulu. Okay, with one pot water we are going to bring this to boil. So we put the head first, because the head you wash first lah the fish eh. Awak cuci dulu. We put in the head first at the bottom. Okay, then you put in the rest of the meat. Awak masukkan daging-daging ikan tongkol ni. Memang wunderva eh. Korang pun dah pandai wunderva, wunderva. You all very clever to speak German with me ya. Alles keine Sprache zu Deutsch. Gitu. Okay. Now and then to bring this to boil, you need all this thing eh. Awak kita masukkan barang-barang ni semua kat dalam periuk ni. Dan kita masakkan dia, rebuskan dia eh. Okay, saya ada setangkai serai. I have one lemongrass. For you who don't know what lemongrass is, lemongrass this length, I peel I bruise it up. Saya ketukkan dia. Lepas tu saya ikatkan dia eh. Lepas tu 2 inci halia di di titik. Dan juga lengkuas 1 inci di titik. Ginger and blue ginger. Okay, you bruise them up. Alright, and I have a bit of kaffir leaf and a bit of basil leaf, daun salam. Hari ni tak ada daun salam hijau. This is another type of bay leaf. You can also use for those who live in Europe. Yang mana tinggal kat Europe tu bolehlah dapatkan daun-daun salam macam gini eh. Okay. So you don't have the green one, it's okay. You can use the Indian version of this bay leaf. Okay. Juga asam keping, berapa keping. You can have a bit of tamarind pulp. And then satu sudu makan serbuk ketumbar, satu serbuk makan serbuk kunyit, dan 2 sudu teh garam. So I have 1 tablespoon of coriander powder, 1 tablespoon of turmeric powder, and also 2 teaspoon of salt. Okay, now all these barang-barang ni semua kita masukkan dalam pot ni terus eh. Put all it inside and bring this to boil eh. Masukkan barang-barang ni. Kita koyak-koyakkan daun limau ni, robek-robekkan dia. We tear this kaffir leaf and all of this as well. Semua ni masukkan ke dalam kuali ni, dalam periuk ni. Put all of this into this pot and bring to boil. Kita rebuskan dia eh. Dengan api yang sederhana with medium heat flame. So we bring this to boil. Okay, kita kasih dia rebus sehingga dia mendidih, until it's until it brings to boil. Kita aduk-adukkan dia sikit lah eh. We stir a little bit, make sure that all this go into there. Kita tutup lah eh, we cover for a while. Okay. Okay, I slow cook this dengan api yang sederhana. Jadi dia mengambil sedikit masa eh. Bila dia dah mengambil sedikit masa, when it's see ah, let me on the light first. There you go. See the became yellow quickly ah. Dia menjadi kuning dengan secepatnya. Okay, so no need to do the old fashioned way. So tak payahlah kita berempahkan dia lagi eh. Tengok ha, okay, see, alright. So once dia dah mendidih, kita dah boleh matikan api. Once it's ready bring to boil, you can just quickly shut off. No need to cook extra. So you here, awak nak kena jaga-jaga eh. So down here you need to observe properly, see, okay. Once all this come up, stop immediately eh. Bila dah mendidih, terus kita berhentikan. Kita angkat ikan ni dengan pelan-pelannya, okay. Okay, kita dah tarik keluar tadi. We already pull out the fish. Now we fry the fish. Kita goreng ikan dia pula eh. Okay, I put even before the oil is getting hot because I scared it will spit out lah. Saya takut dia menterletok. Saya masukkan ikan dia dulu. Okay. Ni kita kita goreng jangan terlalu garing eh. We half cook the fish, we don't fry until it's too hard ah. Kita goreng mamai-mamai je lah kata orang eh. So we half cook the fish. Kau just now already boil right? Ha, yang mana dah berubah warna macam gini, kita angkat, we'll change color, we pick it up, okay? No need to cook, overcook, no need to masak terlalu garing. Minyak dia jangan buang, we don't get rid of the oil we can do something else later eh. Nanti kita akan membuatkan sesuatu, kita akan masak dengan minyak yang sama eh. The good thing about this tuna fish because it's harder meat than the normal fish eh. Ikan tongkol ni isi dia agak lebih keras daripada ikan-ikan biasa eh. There you go, okay. Ni dia yang telah digoreng tadi. Okay, now the next step is bahagian kedua adalah saya ada 3 biji bawang dihiris, okay. Bawang besar, bawang putih dimamar eh. Dalam berapa biji. This one is completely up to you how spicy you want it to be. Tomato 2 biji eh. And I have 3 large onion slice. And then I have a few garlic, which is 5 garlic bruised. And 2 tomatoes cut into 4, potong 4 eh. Dan juga cili saya setengah kilo. Terserah pada anda berapa banyak awak nak. According to how spicy you want, I have fit in some bird eye chili. This is half a kilo eh. Ini setengah kilo sebab saya suka makan cili. And I already de-seeded the chili. Saya dah buang bijinya. Okay, setengah kilo chili bersama cili padi sedikit saya letak. Okay, kita akan menggunakan chopper. We will use a chopper later eh. Bukan sekarang. Kejap lagi later. Okay. Alright, so we're gonna do this. And 1 sudu makan garam. 1 tablespoon of salt. And 2 tablespoon of sugar. 2 sudu makan gula. Lepas tu awak nak taruh lah awak punya Ajinomoto ke apa-apa. Terserah pada anda. You want to put your whatever seasoning. It's completely up to you. Okay. So dengan minyak yang sama kita masukkan bawang-bawang ni semua, bawang putih with the same oil we put in the onions, garlic, tomato. We saute, kita tumiskan dia sampai bawang dia layu eh, until the onion soften. Tabukkan garam sedikit lah. Just a little bit of salt to expedite the cooking. Inilah sedap kalau kita pakai minyak yang sama. If we use the same oil lah that we fry with the fish earlier, because it has all the other rempah on the fish. And you know, you can feel the same taste lah. Awak akan rasa rasa yang sama eh. So if halfway through right now, dalam separuh jalan, kita masukkan cili-cili ni semua. We put in the chili. Okay. Wait, not finish yet. Why you think I put the chili like that? Awak ingat kenapa saya letak chili ni gini eh? Belum habis lagi eh, kawan-kawan. It's not finished. The process ah, is still ongoing. Masih ada lagi satu step yang kita nak kena bikin. There's one more step that we need to do, okay? You don't talk talk much ah. You think I don't know? Jangan cakap mengumpat-ngumpat eh. Kuak, 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 kuak. Kalau dia agak kering, if you think it's a bit dry, you can put a bit of water. Ada balance air kat sini, masukkan air je. Just put a bit of water to moisten up the whole process. Eh? Biar dia lembutkan semua, okay? Let it soften. Okay, dah lembut, kita angkat dia. Eh? Once it's soft, we can pull this out. Kita angkat ni, ha nampak? Angkat lagi, okey, ada proses tahap yang kedua eh. Now for you who do not have a chopper, yang mana tak ada chopper tu, yang ada air sebalance ni eh, boleh pakai untuk kisar eh, untuk pakai kisar biasa. You can use at a normal food processor eh. Those who do not have a chopper like me, you can use a normal food processor, fit in the balance of this juice, okay? Masukkan air yang balance ni eh. Okay, ni dia, kalau kita akan masukkan dalam chopper, we put this into a chopper. Kita masukkan semua dalam ni. Saya menggunakan minyak zaitun. I'm using olive oil. Kita masukkan barang yang telah kita pisah tadi ya. Kita tumis seketika. We saute ya. For a while. Kita dah boleh masukkan garam dan gula. Put in the salt and sugar. Kita masak ni sampai dia kering eh. We saute this until it's slightly drier. So we just keep saute, kita tumiskan dia lagi eh. Kalau gini awak boleh simpan berhari. If like this ah, you cook for a while, you can keep this sambal for quite a few days ah. Nampak. Okay, the taste is completely up to you. If you want to add a bit more, some people they like a little bit more sweet, as you know, it's sambal ah. Ada yang suka taruh garam lebih sikit, ada yang suka taruh gula lebih sikit. Yes, I have a bit of additional. Saya ada taruh garam lebih sikit dan juga gula lebih sikit. Yang tadi tu saya tunjuk. Nanti banyak orang komplain pula lah, terlalu masin, terlalu macam kau masak pula eh. So kita terserah pada anda eh. So it's completely up to you how you want it to taste like, okay? Okay, dengan segala hormatnya eh, dengan minyak-minyak dah naik, okay? You see the oil has already been separated. Dengan segala hormat ni, kita tuanglah semua ikan-ikan kat dalam ni, okay? Gaul semua kasih rata, orang. Right? Tu dia, that's the original belado. Ni dah dia, original of the belado, okay? This is the original Indonesian sambal belado, okay?
Oh wow.
Itu dia belado ikan tongkol original. This is the original version of the Indonesian sambal fish, okay? Oh wow. Selamat kembali kepada sesi cekik menyekik makan memakan eating session time. Oh wow, tu dia ikan belado, the original ikan tongkol eh. The original ikan belado, ikan tongkol. So this is the original Indonesian sambal fish. Correct lah, betul. sebenarnya kalau saya kalau makan kepala ikan saya suka saya kalau makan ikan suka makan kepala-kepala dia eh. Kepala ni tinggal setengah-setengah tadi kasih cik alik. When I eat fish, I like to eat the head, the bony-bony parts, you know, half already give to cik talik already, okay? Alamak, memang marvelous. So this is my half of my part. Cik talik has already pick up his share. Dia dah ambil share dia eh. Jadi tak payah apa-apa lagi lah. Saya pun kena makan banyak-banyak. Okay, ada keropok. Alamak, kata Indonesia eh. We have we going to Indonesia. So we have a bit of keropok. This is pinjau keropok. If you want to know, it's tasteless actually. And it's very nice. I don't know how come tasteless can be nice. Kita pun tak tahu macam mana benda-benda yang tak berasa ni eh, boleh jadi sedap eh. Itulah nikmatnya rasa ni. Yang tengok Allah Ta'ala tu dah bikin kandang. Ha? God has sent you. God send. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, memang fabulous. Oi. Sudah. Meleleh. So sedap. Ini traditional food is so marvelous. Masakan tradisi ni memang sedap. Makanan-makanan traditional ni, this traditional food is so marvelous. I use olive oil the second round. My rice finish really cepatnya. Nasi dah habis. Okay. So I hope to see you again on masak apa masak my style. Mom. Bye.